Either. I think if you learn and experience the world from enough angles, you realize in the end that reality is a secret that you have to find out for yourself. And as long as you're not finding out what the real facts are, you're gonna live in some kind of fishbowl, safe room, playground, and be doing what other people want you to be doing, or what other people think is safe for them for you to do. You know, go play outside. That's the whole regime that we have had. You know, there's this action that I'm supporting, and that is to buy silver and crash the banks. But that's part of a bigger picture, a bigger reality that I think is good to point out and make clear, because that will give you a stable reference of understanding, I think. In my opinion, for me it works very well. What's going on is that as oil was found, the US dominated the oil supply because of its military power, which was of course created by the existence of oil. You know, you had oil burning sea vessels, marine force tanks and airplanes, and without oil there would never have been the possibility to project this type of force. Of course, nuclear weapons came in, but that was only like 30 years after the discovery of oil. So the US had the franchise for oil. It has had the petrodollar, it created it, and it lost the gold standard because it had to have more oil, and it basically used up a lot of it. But the very important thing to realize is that that was all based on military might, on the fact that they were projecting military power. Now, when China came around in the world, it didn't have much military power, so it had to live in the hotel that the US had created for all its tenants, like Europe and all the other countries, which were buying oil in dollars. So they all had to swap money with the US. And for reasons of, let's say, fairness, they also swapped a lot of debt, which gave them dollars to buy oil. And thus, let's say, you can say that the world was supplied with oil under the umbrella of the US. And the US was always taxing the world because it had to pay with dollars and get those dollars for somewhere, and the US got those dollars. What went wrong, which is not the key of my explanation, but what went wrong is of course that the commercial sector exploded, because it was all left open to enterprise. So the oil companies were exploring oil as much as they could, and whatever they found they could sell, and new people started to exist because they could, because there was enough food, and there was always there was always enough for them to live on. So the population exploded. All these new people had to have stuff and do things, and all these things cost oil, and everybody was happy with selling them because everybody was sitting next to this river of oil, grasping whatever came by, getting a little bit of that. That was an economy, as you can call it, that grew and grew and grew on a global scale, basically everywhere. A key factor in that whole economy and a way to make sure that it was limitless was the Federal Reserve in the US and the policies of the US. So the explosive debt policies of the US were a condition for having the explosion in population and the explosion in wealth, of course. But what it basically only was of course, and I've said that before, making paper dollars and playing a game as if that paper dollar was payment for the oil that came from everywhere. It wasn't. It was simply a game that people understood, that basically also kept the myth of the bankers alive, that the population believed in, that fiat currency was worth something, that you could exchange in it. The only reason why we do that, of course, is that we have no alternative. No, there is just a mandated, it's fiat currency. And you get used to it, just like you would get used to having to clean the floor every morning if you live in a slave or in some house where they don't, they use you as a slave or something like that. And you get used to everything. So also to fiat currency. But to allow the whole game to happen and to keep the myth alive that made it possible, fiat currency, to create limitless money, you had to have the Federal Reserve. It was actually essential, and it was a private enterprise. It was colluding with the other private enterprises and the oil companies and everybody and the military industrial complex, such that the governments were basically irrelevant. They were like well, the bartender in a cafe that is owned by somebody else. They were trying to keep the customers happy, try to keep things organized, and they would get into international conflicts. But we all know that on top of that whole international conflict system is a couple of things, like an international court of justice, an international IMF, a World Bank, and of course the BI, Bank of International Settlements. These people, and they have been around for a long time. They've basically been managing the depletion of the oil reserves. And the point is that, of course, they had been doing that with China. They took China on board. And China was very, I think they had a good deal. They got a lot of oil because they bought US dollars, and they gave their people something to do and shipped the stuff to the US. And now they have the manufacturing capacity and etc. Now, what's been happening for the past 4 years, 5 years, is two things. First of all, you know, the US is trying to destroy its economy for a very sensible reason, because it is a lethal. It's a lethal state. It's like the tempo on which it has been operating is not sustainable, and everybody knows that. It has to calm down. It has to slow down, but it is under control of the bankers and the international companies, etc. They won't give up. They are like the tuna fisher that will go on fishing until all the tuna are dead. So one factor is that you, even in order to stop them, you have to blow it up. You have to blow it up. In order to kill the beast, you have to feed it so much that it will basically rupture its stomach and die. And that's the approach that has been taken up until now. Banks and the people that are enjoying the oil stream, that are enjoying the revenues, are enjoying the economy, that are the main profiteers of the economy, as we can recognize very clearly. You know, people that do next to nothing and reap in millions and millions, they're not happy with it. They're not cooperating. So that's why you have, I think, the Federal Reserve policy at the moment. It is to destroy the system, very on purpose, and for a very basic reason, which is independent of China, and can be simply described as, you know, if you're going to crash into a wall, you might want to hit the brakes, you know, sometimes before, and then you might still crash into it, but it might be less hurtful. Now China comes in, and they also have a massive population, and they're not idiots. They're actually quite, and they're very old culture. So they're basically, you know, maybe not on the national scale, but locally, they're very tightly knit, and they're very, they have a different mentality, basically. They have a completely different mentality, different from the people that now still control the U.S. while their control is basically being undermined and destroyed. You know, and that's why I'm in favor of this whole buy silver effort, because it does undermine the structure that keeps the dangerous process of depleting the oil and feeding the whole economy. It undermines that. It creates lots of problems for that. But that's another story. China has been gaining in military strength for the last 20 years, of course. You know, they have every reason. They have Russia on the border, and they have Japan on the other side, although Japan is not armed and not very dangerous yet. But they at a certain point they said, well, yeah, but you know, we want to control everything. We don't want to live in a situation where our food supply, which is the oil, can be taken away from us. just like that. You know, if the US stops selling treasury bonds and stops selling dollars, or basically puts some marine vessels, some aircraft carriers between China and Iran and China and Afghanistan, or wherever the oil comes from, it's China is done. It hasn't have any power, and it needs the military strength to defeat that, in case. It's very logical. You cannot survive if somebody can suddenly cut off your oxygen. You can't accept that. So a main drive has to be that you have the power to defeat that cutoff, that you can cut through that and can force yourself to be supplied, or at least threaten so much destruction that the enemy, between brackets, will not cut off the supply. As the US is doing right now. So China developed the military power to defeat the US. It had to.